Hello friends. Welcome to my channel Dheeraj Kumar. And in today's video I am going to talk about the LG C8 OLED TV. So, without further delay, let's get started. First start with design and features. The last C-series TV from LG featured a modest central pedestal, but the LG C8 OLED is a little different. The metal slab is now longer and it curves forwards. This is to redirect sound from the down-firing speakers so it fires forwards. The unit is certainly more stable than other TVs with central pedestals, but you'll need a wider table or bench to accommodate it. The C8's screen is about the thickness of 6 credit cards, and the bezel isn't substantial. The bottom half of the back houses all the electronics, which takes the thickness to about 5 centimeters. Inputs include 4 HDMI ports, all of which support 4K and HDR input. The Magic Remote makes a welcome return. It's a bit large at first sight but is actually a joy to use. It has 3 control schemes in one: standard buttons, a wheel for menu scrolling, plus gyroscopes and accelerometers to control an on-screen cursor. Another welcome sight is LG's webOS interface, which has essentially defined how smart TVs ought to behave. Over the years the system has been tweaked, but the core offering remains the same. The menu is a handy pop-up bar with a bunch of cards for apps, inputs, and favorite channels. You may drag and drop them where you wish, navigate with the pointer, or go old school and press buttons. Now, talk about specification. The new Alpha 9 chip powers this OLED TV. LG tells that the Alpha 9 excels at noise reduction, sharpness, and color handling, all especially important if you're upscaling non-4K content. There's also a new dynamic tone mapping feature which adds dynamic adjustments to static metadata signals. Speaking of which, LG continues to support the greatest number of HDR formats. The LG C8 OLED will accept the standard HDR10, the dynamic metadata toting Dolby Vision, the broadcast-friendly HLG and advanced HDR by Technicolor. The only one missing is HDR10+. The company tells that it's focusing on processor tech this year, because the panel tech hasn't changed much. We're still dealing with a 10-bit panel with a 4K Ultra HD resolution and a marginally increased peak brightness of just over 800 nits. As for sound, the most noteworthy feature on the specs sheet is Dolby Atmos. This TV can't provide the full dome of sound experience like a full fat Atmos system with ceiling speakers, but it actually succeeds in providing a good sense of space. Finally, another year, another gorgeous and great value OLED from LG. So that's all in this video, catch you later, till then, bye.